Howdy, folks. Hope you're all doing well. Yeah, I'm gonna be starting through a new playthrough of this game, Signalis. Was given to me as a gift from my brother some amount of time ago. I couldn't say with any accuracy. Seemed like an interesting game, and I've kind of had my eye on playing it, so it's jumped the queue in terms of games in my backlog. Yeah, was gonna give this a shot and see what it's kind of all about. Haven't really seen anything about the game, though I did quote-unquote play for 1 or 2 minutes just to test out the streaming settings and that sort of thing. So we are going to get started with this one and just discover as we go along. For the warning that preceded the game about photo light sensitivity and stuff like that, there are some settings to turn that off. I have turned those off. There's also some other stuff that has to do with, like, you know, making it more streamer friendly or something for video capture. So I fiddled around with those settings, but yeah. Otherwise, let's boogie. Although it has been a moment since I actually tested the settings, so I may have to refer to the controls. So I'm not sure I rightly remember them. Well, obviously some of them. Penrose-type vessel field operations manual. Penrose-type vessels of the USN, People's Navy, are low-cost space exploration vessels deployed beyond the solar system's edge in the search for planets and moons fit for habitation or rich in natural resources to support the continuous growth of our great nation. All Penrose vessels are piloted by a Gestalt Scout officer supported by a land survey ship Technician Replica, LSTR. This partner system of Gestalt Replica cooperation has proved successful in countless previous scout operations. Mutual control and support allow both the Gestalt officer and the Technician Replica to perform at their optimal capacity. Once the vessel is catapulted towards the edge of the solar system by an orbital mass driver, the pilot may adjust the course from the flight deck, while the replica will take care of mechanical maintenance of the vessel. Curious. Diagnostic systems for the cryogenic capsule. Can I investigate more in the environment then? No. I was just noticing the difference between, like, so, like, this is being highlighted, definitely for something for me to interact with, but, like, this is not, like, highlighting anything. Go this way. This place has been trashed. Smeared diary page. Woke up from cryo in empty mess hall. I was wondering Elster was looking out from the flight deck. Like some lost in thought, sometimes I feel something. His home? The Gestalt officer's sleeping bunk. Yeah, I was actually going to say, like, I'm not sure how much guiding the game is doing as far as the lighting. So, like, the light over here is, like, kind of blinking or a little bit more dim. So there's no entry. Lock is defective. Door can't be open. And I was like, and it's also dim over here, which means that I must not be able to go this way. But apparently that's not true. LSTR features Repair Logic Module. Serving our great nation as ship technicians aboard the scout vessels of the Penrose program, LSTR type replicas like yourself are equipped with a specialized Repair Logic Module, RLM, allowing them to quickly and easily repair both themselves and important mission equipment. Accessing the RLM functions, enter the inventory screen by pressing Tab, select the item to repair. Press F to open the command menu. Select combine to enter the combine mode. While in combine mode, select a second item to repair. Press F again to combine both items. To repair damage to the replica body, select a suitable repair item and simply choose the use option from the command menu. Sometimes it can be helpful to take a good look at an object from all sides. Select the Inspect option in the command menu to enter Inspect mode. While in Inspect, use WASD to rotate the item to look at it from all sides. Okay. So I guess I don't have anything right now. Oh. This diagnostics. No module, memory. I guess these are our different entries, and then diagnostics. Over-clustered, hypersensitive, fragmented, catatonic. Everything nominal right now. And then, yeah, I can't open the action menu because I don't have anything. And then this will be the map. Okay, then we can also see which doors are open and which doors are closed right now. Bro, there's duct tape. Jackpot. Penrose 512, status, critical system failure detected, location, unknown planetary surface. Report, crew status, a young Gestalt pilot, no signal. LSTR 512 replica unit active, mess hall. Hard landing on surface, has damaged critical systems. Warning, surface temperature critically low, wear protective clothing during AVA. Yep. Okay. Yep. Anything else for me to look at here? Okay. Guess I'm the replica unit then. This way, not this way. The suit has been removed from the case. Oh, you can actually look around more. I can use that. There's an Ava suit in the case. Yes. Can I open it? Airlock controls locked. Insert key card. Okay. The interface changing is interesting. Ship is crashed in an icy landscape. Ship's control panel. Judging from the readout, there's no chance it'll ever fly again. That's bad. Starboard controls panel. Controls aren't responding to any input. Probably an electrical failure. Ship's control panel, it's a lost cause. Port controls panel. There's been a critical system failure due to the hard landing. The landing and docking assist monitor. It's of no use to me now. Faded photograph is stuck to the LDAM controls. Pick up photograph. I have picked up the photograph. Oh, sweet. I can scroll faster using the mouse and the keyboard at the same time. Photograph taken on self-developing film despite the damage. Ariane Young can still be seen on it. I guess that's the Gestalt pylon. Transparent polypropylene-based pressure-sensitive tape that can be used for joining, sealing, attaching, and mending. Right, so you can rotate things on your own. And then yes. Looks like the pigment was damaged by the time and exposure to the elements. Alright, well I guess we'll head back to that control panel. It even says cryo on the top, so I'm presuming the red ones are ones that we should press. So let's do that. Two pieces of a key snapped in half lie inside the cryogenic pod. Pick up the airlock key. Magnetic key card that allows access to the Penrose's airlock controls. It snapped in half. And covered in marinara. Tape that back together. Oh man, I used the entire roll of tape. What if I needed that duct tape for something? Other than the key card, you know, obviously. moment. Okay. Can I use it here? Use airlock key. Yes. Cycle confirmed. Ship also appeared to be covered in something. Didn't think I was in for another winter survival game, but here we are. What the hell? Doesn't seem like part of the ship and doesn't seem natural. There's a strange hole leading deep into the ground. There's a faint light glowing in the deep. Crawl into the hole. I guess so. An ancient-looking tome is lying on the table. It feels like it is calling to me. Pick up the king in yellow. Oh dear. Message. I don't know if I should be following my inclination to create holes or secretly dig rows. Let's suffice. Things have learned to walk that ought to crawl. Creepy. Remember our promise. came all the way here to find her. There's no turning back now. Bathroom stalls in various states of disrepair. Photograph taken on self-developing film. Despite the damage, Alina Sio can still be seen on it. This photograph has changed. Has it? I mean, definitely the back of it, which used to have the cryo code on it. But the front as well? I also don't have the book. Get here. The surface access lift. I don't need to go back. There's a key card with a note taped to the window of the reception. Due to staff shortage, report new arrivals at classroom 4C, northeast. Pick up receptionist key. May as well. Lang Orbital Interchange, S-23, Sierpinski Facility, Transit Station. Welcome to Sierpinski Facility. Welcome to S-23 Sierpinski. You've been selected or have elected to be relocated by Aeon to S-23 Sierpinski, located on Lang at the frontier of the solar system. S-23 Sierpinski is the perfect place for a new beginning. At our prestigious... something, vocational school facility, redacted, you will learn new skills to shape your future as a productive citizen of our wonderful nation. Here you will learn all about mineral extraction, ore refinement, munitions production, helping the war effort against the remnants of the Empire. And of course, learning is not just about theory. Aeon lets you earn your share while practicing your new craft right at the workplace. Concerned about your family, friends, former colleagues? Ask a protector about our ration sharing plan. A portion of your ration marks will be sent to a beneficiary of your choice. Nice little piece of propaganda. Okay, we're not going that way. Used receptionist key. Does it go away? It does. I am being watched. Locked. Requires a key. Dank on Dirigal. The rule of six. Remember the rule of six. Never carry more than six items on your person. Private property is a privilege. Keep your pockets empty and your bag light. Is that me too? I guess so. Lock is defective and cannot be opened. Can't go this way, nor this way. I did said northeast, so I suppose we'll head there first. What is this? A dead Eula unit? She's in a horrible state. Infected-looking biocomponents are bulging out of her damaged shell. What happened to her that would cause this? Another dead Eula unit. Why was she abandoned here? Oh, interesting. So I do actually have to approach the doors to know what their lock status is or not. An aperture card microfilm viewer. If I had an aperture card, I could view its content here. Dictionary. Replica. Noun, plural, replicas, shortened from archaic replicant, biomechanical person, synthetic reproduction of a gestalt, biological culture grafted onto an artificial endoskeleton and enclosed in a protective exoskeleton. Gestalt, noun, plural, gestalts, shortened from archaic ergestalt, original shape, compare, archetype, prototype, a person that is not a replica. A simple first aid kit. Can't use any of these since they're not designed for replicas. Oh. I'm stuck. There's a box. Okay. Is how I save the game. Very good. Service request form F29. Date of filing, service request form 84214. Full protector ID of unit filing request ULRS2309 replica. Status staff, department redacted, full protector ID of unit processing request, ARRS2303 replica. Service object, Mondin. Pronunciation of that is beyond me. Tuchter. High security wall safe, numeric keypad, location of object, classroom 4B. Description, the wall safe in classroom 4B keeps resetting to the default combination. What's the point of the whole radio code broadcasting system if our safe can only be opened with the code in the manual? No, it's the same thing. Keep records. Protocol, everything. Remember, if you didn't write it down, it never happened. It's my Llama Llama 2 playthrough. Get the right forms from administration and save your files frequently. Memorandum, wool safe codes. It has come to my attention that at least one worker might be aware of the code broadcasting frequencies for the protector wall safes. Any workers connected to this leak are to be interrogated until the culprit is found. I'm restricting all radio privileges for workers until further notice. Adler. Okay, we can continue east, I suppose. Not this way, nor here. I can't go that way. Whoa. An Elster unit. You should leave this place. This facility is lost. Turn back before it's too late. I'm looking for this woman. Have you seen her? I don't know her, but she might be one of the workers. All Gestalt workers were sent to the mine below the facility. If she's still alive, she's probably down there. There's an access elevator to the mine shaft, one level below, but you'll need an administrator's key to use it. I'll be out of here as soon as this repair patch stops my bleeding. You should get out of here, too. I don't know who that woman is, but she's probably dead by now. If you still want to go, good luck. Access elevator. Okay. Protector key. I will. Okay, can't go this way. This is locked. And this is also locked. Classroom key required. Alright. Well, she's in a bad way. Okay, so I can explore a little bit more over here. And then I guess it's back here, maybe? Wait, is this 4B? Yeah, there's a wall safe in here then. No running in the hallways. Be mindful of your neighbors. Everyone can hear you run. Noted. So I know it's likely reset to whatever the default is. I just don't know what the default is. Or at least I don't think so. Yeah, it keeps resetting the default combination. Radio code processing, open with the code in the manual. I suppose I could try 2309, but I doubt it. Didn't think so. Go down here? No. I used protector key. Memorandum terminology. I announce the following by order of Aeon. Due to recent events, in accordance with the new Aeon Public Interest Media Regulation AGM 87, the term redacted, which is currently in use in various Aeon facilities and no longer permissible, and must no longer be used. Premises and departments that are currently using the term are to be immediately renamed. Management personnel shall black out the term from all signage and documents until a replacement terminology is announced by Aeon. With immediate effect, usage of the term in conversation and correspondence is an offense, obscenity to the state, to be punished with 2 cycles of double work shift. It may not be easy, but we all have to do our part here. Always remember, our language shapes our world. A perfect world requires a perfect language. Adler. But how do I know what I'm not supposed to say if you won't tell me what it is? Can I do anything with this cable? Apparently no. I will take this pistol. Aperture card? I'll also take that. Type 75 pistol user manual. The Type 75 pistol is a short recoil operated, locked breech semi-automatic pistol chambered in 10x20mm. This reliable, versatile handgun is a standard issue sidearm for Aeon Protector Controller staff. Replica users, remember to first equip the Type 75 pistol in the inventory screen to designate the pistol as your primary weapon for the targeting module. To deploy the weapon, hold right mouse button to disengage the safety and enter targeting mode. While in targeting mode, space and left trigger will both fire the weapon. R will initiate a reload. Remember, do not waste ammunition, for it is a resource of the nation. When a target is down, try to finish it off by kicking or hitting it with a baton to preserve ammunition. Okay. I can see an empty classroom on the other side of the window. The glass seems like it's tinted, or a one-way mirror. Can I look at the computer? Nope. Okay. All right. I am packing heat. Card with a piece of microfilm mounted inside. I suppose we can go and have a look at this on the computer then. Oh, hello. Can I interrupt you? You don't belong here either, do you? I'm Issa. Issa Ito. You should be careful. There's something wrong with this place. You don't say. I don't know what happened, but it's probably dangerous to go any further. That's okay. I understand. I have something I need to do, too. Take care. I hope you find who you're looking for. Well, first I want to have a look at the... He says note. Erica, if you find this note, despite everything that's happened, I've come to look for you, Issa. Let's use the aperture card. Mondendoktor, high security wall safe, numeric. Ah, the wall safe complies with USIN Public Safety Equipment Regulations 41 and 43 and features a high-density Kraftstahl door secured with a numeric keypad, proudly produced on Heimat by VEB Mondendoktor. Instruction for use. Enter the code using the keypad. Press the confirm key in the lower right corner. If correct, a green light will light up. Rotate the dial on the left to open the door. To clear any previously entered digits, press the E key in the lower left. First time setup, enter the factory default code 2045112 to open the safe. While the door is open, enter the desired new code in the keypad and press and hold the confirm key for 10 seconds until the green light lights up. 204512 then. There we go. I wonder if this thing is going to get back up at some point. Thank you. classroom key. Indeed, I shall. Is this anything? No. I was curious if the label on the inside of the safe is probably some warranty information or something. Who knows? As they said, they're gone now. Repair patch. A sealed single-use adhesive patch containing a coagulation agent to patch up damaged areas restores a small amount of health over time. Ten millimeter ammo. 10. Yes. Okay, so question. I have 7 bullets. At the hazard of... Yeah, I just want to answer the question. So I reload, and okay. So yeah, you're not dumping the magazine and losing the rounds. Good to know. Okay. I will attend to the very obvious hole in the middle of the room shortly, but is there anything else in here? Doesn't look like it. There's a hole in the ground. It looks like I can drop down safely. Let's go. Ceiling has collapsed, and there's no way through. A dead Yula unit, the synthetic skin and hair on her head were replaced with a layer of thin, wet gauze. Parts of her polyethylene shell are missing, exposing her biocomponents. I wonder how this happened. That's a lot of garbage bags. Unlocks from the other side. Service request form. Star. That was the one that we ran into. Status guard, worker quarters. Service object, Himmel tape D, automatic security door. Worker block, A6 corridor. Lock on the staff door, and A6 is jammed again, requesting a locksmith. The electronics reset key is nowhere to be found. I set up a lock-picking kit, but management bumped the elevator engines up in priority, so next shift we'll have to pick the lock. Just trial and error at this point. Find me if you need a key to open the service hatch, or ask management. Whatever. Fünf. Service hatch key required. Alright. Kick them while they're down. worker sleeping units. In facilities like these small caged bunks are all a Gestalt worker can call their own. Worker's uniform looks old and worn. Alina's diary. Feeling a little lightheaded today. I hope it's not that new flu that seems to be going around. Can't afford to miss any more shifts. That storch at the factory was chewing me out for what felt like hours. For fainting at work the last time I got a cold. I haven't seen Elster the last few days. I hope she's okay. More and more people go missing in the mine lately. Including replicas. Not even the protectors seem to be safe. The protectors have been worried lately. They're hiding something. There's less of them. Ration plan keeps changing. Alina says I am imagining. At them I can feel their fear like it's my own. What are they scared of? An oscillating fan is mounted on the wall. Okay, we can go that way. Is someone watching? It's locked. West wing key required. The elevator is out of order. Oh yeah. Let's see. I wasn't just carefully looking at this diagram. I was cooking up a sneeze that did not want to come out, and still did not. Vertical map of S-23 Sierpinski. Laying orbital. Surface. Factory. Something redacted. Workers, hospital wing. Personnel, protector, operational command. And then mine access. Okay. Elevator controls locked. Insert protector identification. Service hatch key. All taken. Need a protector identification card to unlock the elevator control panel. Okay. Well, I guess we're leaving. I will use the service hatch game. Okay. Oh, this is the lockpick. Oh, I see. I'm moving. I was looking at the display down here, but it's moving the different pieces on this. Let's see. One could be shallower. Let me see. So these ones need to be deeper. Like that. Where does this need to be deeper still? I think that this threshold needs to be on at the bottom. Not a locksmith. So, like, that would be correct for this one. Okay. Yeah, so this would need to be deeper. This one could be, well, on par with that. And then here? Not quite. Also not quite. There? Yeah, there we go. East wing key required. Unlocks from the other side. Memorandum, wall safe codes. Come to my attention that at least one worker might be aware of the code broadcasting frequencies for the particular. Right. Read this one. Different safe. So different safe code. We'll try it anyway. Yeah. I'm quite sure that that was it, but we will have a look. And now I'm like, I did put that in correctly, right? 204512. Yeah. Okay. But yeah, it's a different icon on the safe as well. Disposable sunbrod 2. My inventory space is leaves a little something to be desired. Get some more 10mm ammo. Wunderwaffen. Super weapons of our nation in the battle against the Empire. Falke units. East wing key. Well, I should be able to use this very soon. Interrogation report. Subject worker. S23A6514. Chen Wilhelm. offense, contraband found in locker, result confession, punishment no food, 3 cycles. Wong, Michaela, illegal use of radio, result confession, punishment ISO, 2 cycles. Oh man, put him in the ISO cubes. Wong, Wolfgang, illegal use of radio, expired during interrogation, punishment none. Well, they let them off easy, I guess. Huo, Franz, obscenity to the state, passed out during interrogation, double work shift, 2 cycles. Huang, Emily, trespassing, expired during interrogation, punishment none. Oh, that was what it was. Okay. I will pick up the disposable stem rods. Electro-impulse devices. Due to recent events, all facility staff members are encouraged to familiarize themselves with the use of the electro-impulse devices. We've been supplied with a shipment of EIG-2 disposable stun prods for training purposes. Please refer to the enclosed handbook for more information. The EIG-2 stun prod is a single-use, short-range, disposable, non-lethal solution for incapacitating non-cooperative individuals. It can be equipped to the tool slot in the inventory screen. Once equipped, it will be shown in the lower left of the inventory screen. EIG stun prod can be used with one hand while on the move and even while aiming another weapon. Once equipped to use the stun prod, simply press C when facing a nearby enemy. Warning, high voltage electric discharge may arc to individuals close to the target. Use with care. Do not deploy on the elderly, pregnant, or individuals with known heart disease unless absolutely necessary. Dispose of stun prod properly after use. Right. That does take up more inventory space. So I can investigate these other rooms, but I'm going to go make use of the key first, just so that it's not in my inventory. It's a storage locker. Oh man. Okay. So put that away. I don't know if I should keep the photograph on me. I mean, we showed that other replica unit. It's like, Do you know this boy? But for now, I'll put it away. Okay. I will throw another repair patch in here. Investigate the other room before we bother saving. Box is locked. Looks like it requires some sort of square-shaped key. Well, just so long as it doesn't have, like, you know, a club or a spade icon on it. Then later when I find a club or, you know, spade-shaped key, then I'll know exactly where it's supposed to go.